goes. There it goes. Right on down. I'm gonna have some trees over there, I think, so I'm not worried about it over there. You know me, I always want to have a big tree. There. If you happen to have, I know you won't, but if you happen to have a little spot in your painting that you're not real pleased with, you know, trees cover a multitude of sins. And no, you can't cover up your whole canvas. I know your painting is better than that. Climb right up in here. Get a little touch more of the blue. There we go. That little tree lives right there. And maybe it goes out over here this direction. So it looks like there's a little peak right there. Sometimes it's fun in your painting to begin putting projections that are closer to you. By that I mean big rocks and stuff.
This is an emergency broadcast from the BBC. Information of a possible nuclear strike against this country has been received. The current threat level is critical, meaning an attack is imminent. Civilians are advised to stay in their homes. Evacuations are currently taking place in the London.
Day 412, entry log. Today's viewers of, drumroll please. That's right, you guessed it, a mountain range and a lake. However, I did add a happy little cottage as well. Bob's idea, not mine. My calendar tells me that tomorrow is the first day of spring, so I'll probably do a field or some flowers or something. I've done my exercises for today. I'm currently at max 75 push-ups, 83 sit-ups, and max 1 minute 15 plank. I'm working on my breathing, and I'll probably pen in a ventilation drill at some point today, I'm not too sure. I'm afraid to report that as of yet there's been no signs of life or outside communication. It's likely that our proximity to London means that nothing survived above ground. And, well, if it does, I don't want to think about it. We're a long way off, but I think at some point in the future I'd like to go out and I'd like to make...
Makes sense when you're painting, you understand. There, we'll come back and smooth all that out in a minute. There we go.
This is an emergency broadcast from the BBC. Information of a possible nuclear strike against this country has been received.
Hey! You need to come with me right now! Look, the warning, the 4 minute warning! I'm trying to save you! Find shelter!
Operations are currently taking place in the London area. All motorways and airports have been closed for military use.
Shit! My radio! Day 413. I haven't heard the sound again. I spent all day today checking the pipes, the ventilation to see if the sound could be coming from there, but nothing. Nothing. I guess we'll just have to wait and see. I've been having my nightmares again. The same thing. I should have saved them. I should have saved them. If they had just listened to me, if they had just understood my fear. Then maybe I wouldn't be alone right now.
Every time I look into your loving eyes, I see a love that money just can't buy. One look from you, I drift away. I pray that you Anything you want, you got it. Anything you need, you got it. Anything at all, you got it. Baby.
Hello! Can you hear me? I'm him! Back again! Please knock again! Please! I just want to know who you are! Are you human? Are you here to save me? Please! Just knock again, please! Anything! Anything!
Today's painting I did with Bob's son, it was nice. I like it when other people come to visit. I haven't heard the sounds again. Doesn't stop me expecting it though. It's a strange feeling. I'm in a constant state of fear and excitement. I feel like a moth. Drawn in by something that could hurt me. Or could it? Maybe they're trying to help. They. I say that as if I know who they are. Maybe they're not even human. The randomness of the sound suggests that it's not. As if they're even real. Could be the pipes. Could be, My nightmares are getting worse. I'm getting to doubt everything. It's like a gnawing darkness in my stomach, like something rotten, spreading, through my insides deeper and deeper and deeper. And then, I don't know if it's the radiation or the isolation. Either way, I'm not sure how much more I can take of this.
Paint a picture, and I could paint the kind of world that I wanted. It was clean, it was sparkling, shiny, beautiful, no pollution, nobody upset. Everybody was happy in this world. Okay, now we can wash the old brush. We wash our brushes with odorless thinner, shake them off. Little yellow ochre, and instantly, because there's blue in that color, we have a nice, gorgeous green. Okay? Now then, let's go up here with that green, and let's put a few little
indicators. Bob, what the fuck?
Some nice highlights.
What was that?
Some of these. I don't want it to get too bright, though. I want to keep this quite dark.
Is this you?
This old tree needs a few.
Have you been doing this? Is up?
Leave him out. There we go.
I thought you were my friend! I trusted you!
Darker as it gets down.
Look at me!
There.
Look at me! Go! Leave me alone!
Gotta stand tall out here in the sunshine. Say hello to the mountain and all the little creatures. Let's go ahead. We'll put a few little highlights here and there on it. There. All right. Okay. These trees. Now, some of these trees I'm gonna leave naked. I'm not gonna put any.
I'm sorry, Bob.
Because I want them to look like they're farther away, back and behind. Very dark. Secret little things are happening in there.
I can't see this anymore.
Now then, we'll take a little bit of the titanium white, allow it to pick up some of that tree color, and begin putting in some nice snowy areas. You want it to pick up that tree color because automatically that'll make the indication of some little shadows.
Day 432. The noises continue. They are unending. I've decided that I'm going to leave my shelter today to try and find out what it is. I'm going to end it.
you've been living underneath the garden for 2 years.
432 days.
Ah, right.
Good. Two sugars, right?
Thank you.
Okay, so let me get this super clear. You've been living in a homemade nuclear bunker in your garden for nearly 2 years. Why?
Because of the bombs. The warning on the TV, it said that we were under attack. What happened with the bombs?
Well, nothing.
Yeah, maybe a year and a bit ago, suppose you know when, we had a false alarm.
A false alarm? So there were no bombs?
Well, there were, kind of. Sorry, do you need that gun?
Oh, sorry.
So yeah, that was a real alert, but the bombs never came. I remember I was at work and we all just stood there and shat ourselves. And a little while later, it was just nothing. We had an all clear and then later on the news, there was just a bunch of people speculating about what happened.
Yeah, in the end they just said it was a failed attempt of...
North Korea or something.
Yeah, anyway, turned out the bombs weren't nuclear and then ended up flopping some sea somewhere. And after one short nothingy war later and some bullshit from politicians about disarmament, and you're pretty much up to date. I can imagine this is pretty hard for you to get your head around.
So why now? After all that time in a bunker, why'd you come up now?
The banging.
The banging?
I thought everyone was gone. I thought if they haven't prepped like I did, and they were this close to the target, then they were dead. And it took me some time to realize that, but I got there. And then I start hearing this banging. This sound against my hatch. And at first it's only a little bit, but then it's constant. It's always happening. So I came out here to make it stop.
When did it start?
A few weeks ago, maybe.
Oh, Jesus. That's about the time when we moved in. Mm. They said the guy that used to live here vanished and eventually they put it back on the market. Susie's been spending most time in the garden, mostly bouncing balls off that grate. She's been spouting nonsense about there being some sort of ghost living in there. I told her she was being silly, but I suppose it wasn't really nonsense after all.
I see. Makes sense, I guess.
So is there anyone you need to call? Yeah, police or council?
No, I'm fine, thank you. I'll survive this long. I'm just gonna go and get my stuff. Thank you for the tea.
Day 432. Final entry. I'm gonna be safe now.
Okay, Christ. Okay, this must be some sort of dream. I'm calling the police.
What? Why? He seems nice. And he's been through a lot.
He lives in a hole in the garden and he's got a gun. We're lucky we got away with just a cup of tea.
What was that? Anything you want, you got it.